Hello everyone, and welcome back to Factorio. We are back at long last, and we are playing with Bob's Angel mod. A Bob's mods and Angel's mods. Angel's Infinite Ores and Infinite and Refining and RSO, and it's going to be a big, long world, and I still have to remember, there we are, how to play this game. Now, because I have made my life kind of obscenely complicated here, I have decided it is not in my best interest to fuss around with. I'm not gonna be doing any fussing around with no crafting and stuff. Oh, I was so happy when this was added. Say goodbye to the stupid rock without guns. Best part is I needed some stone to get a second refinery online. Okay. Just gotta remember I'm not playing Fallout 4 now, so there's some different... Oh, those are new. I wonder why I have geodes to start. Oh, no, I just got those off the, right. Alright. Now, I believe, yes, I did. I installed a no hand mining mod. So, the main reason I did that, to be perfectly frank, was that I was really tired of winding up with, random ores in my inventory last time around, so this will prevent that from happening, at least from mining. Now, Angel's Mods, Angel's Infinite Ores, adds a few interesting features. The main feature of it is these special ores that require specialized refining. They produce the primary product first, so in this case, stearatite produces copper and then iron as its primary two. And then the other important one, sapphire, produces iron, then copper, in that order. So, actually, what I need to do right now is grab this, and I need to get a little bit of iron. We're going to dump it straight into this thing right here, which is a special kind of refinery specifically for... these ores. It just separates it out into something that can then be smelted. And so that can be smelted into iron, if memory serves. So we'll do that to get our iron production off the ground. Now to make one of those... Ooh, research tree. Very different. We'll have a look at that later. Not going to be doing any researching. I can actually make one now, which means I can separate out the production of the two different kinds of... ores immediately, which will be nice. All I need now is some iron, and I can make myself a new burner miner. There we go. That takes care of that. Get that going, and then now stone. This, I believe, can be crafted. There we are, straight from the crushed stone, no fanciness required. There we go. And just keep that going. We'll get another burner miner going so we can get the full. Cyclical ore mining go.
Super bad cave.
Lots of room for the initial base here. That's primarily to prevent any hiccups. There we go. All right. That takes care of the coal problem permanently. at least until I get electric mines going. Now, we don't have a lot of water. I think I'm going to use some of these small ponds for our initial water, or initial power plant. So yeah, our goal right now will be to get some of that off the ground. Actually, I need to stop using wood for any smelting related stuff. So that I can use the wood for circuit boards. Now our next burner miner will go towards the copper patch right here. We're going to call it a copper patch for now, even though that's more than that. As soon as we get tier 2 refining, we'll actually be getting both copper and iron out of both of these patches. Now I've set myself a couple... I thought I said no. Okay. I'll just have to... Maybe I didn't install that. I was planning on installing that, but maybe it didn't make it. I don't know. Quite possible. Alright, so hopefully that will be our last burner miner. Make some coal, some stone, and then a smelter. Alright, I think I've got everything I need to get the second one set up. So first thing on my agenda is going to be inserters. So we're actually going to get automation 1. Hold on, whoa, okay. Oh, I see. Oh, wow. Holy smokes. Okay. Automation. Where's our first... Wow, this is... Okay, is that technologies? Yes, it is. Okay. I don't already have access to inserters, do I? Oh, I do. Will you look at that? Apparently they've changed the tech around a little and made inserters available from square one. So that'll make this a little easier. All right, one burner inserter right there. Going straight into a refining machine. Why did that just stop? Oh, because it had nowhere to go yet. And autofill is doing its thing. And then we'll put one square and then a smelter. This apparently requires a fair bit of extra. How much is it going to require? 3 crushed steratite. So the other reason to boost our refining tech is we'll actually get more out of the ore crusher and the when we go to tier 2. See, there we are, crushed sapphire ore sorting. So that gets us just this next tier, this first tier gets us the first thing. Since I don't have to worry about researching inserters right away. There we go. So we're going to do this. Now, the only catch is that it won't actually work until we get power. Darn it. Okay. Focus. So we're going to need power. Now, there's a lot of different mods in here. Let's see. We need lots and lots and lots of iron. Actually means I might start smelting more of it. Split it down the middle. There we go. I don't even know why I have some of that, but... So the plan with this one, the mod, with this kit, is we're going to go for a big rail game. That's sort of what I'm thinking. A long haul, lots of long haul railways. Yeah, just intending on covering lots and lots of ground. I guess I could build burner inserters, or burner. Those are going to be awfully polluty, so maybe I shouldn't do that. Alright, well, step one, water pump down. So we'll run the first power line out this way. So we're going to need about three of these boilers for a steam engine. Okay, boom, boom, boom. Okay. Two, three, and one boiler. And in theory, that should be enough. Get the basics. Hold on, I thought I said three of these. There we go. Now, obviously, this is going to require some manual feeding for a while. Okay, power plants. Power lines. We're going to need a few of these. And we're also going to need our first research facility. Okay, and then there we go. Mod that I'm missing, I believe, is the one that makes it easier to walk through the trees. Well, maybe I did, maybe I'm not. That could just be my imagination. Okay. Power's almost there. Now what do I need for the lab? I need a whole bunch of copper, is all I'm missing. Somehow that doesn't surprise me in the slightest. Good news is, copper is something I'm actually manufacturing faster now. Now, we also need to start putting the stone in a box, but that's going to require smart inserters, actually. There we go. Let's get this research almost set up here. All right, well, it's going to take some doing to get ourselves up and running here. I mean, my primary goal is going to be to get to railway as soon as possible so I can start spreading out. I don't want to do too much distributed, I don't want to run out of the core ores before I can get to, a better location. Okay. So then our second one is going to be our second tech after mechanical refining will be most likely probably one of the automation techs so that I can start manufacturing the there we go. There we go. Oh, more coal. Need our coal. Excellent. There we go. Excellent. All right, now these are from flow control. Oh, by the way, yeah, I installed a mod called Squeak Through. It should make it a lot easier to traverse complex factories. It lets me squeeze through small patches or through densely crowded areas. Ooh, I noticed the graphics have been amped up a little. I think I might actually be going at this wrong. Mechanical refining is great, but I think automation... Yeah, we'll get automation first, because then I'll actually be able to yeah, with mechanical refining, or sorry, with automation, I'll be able to actually start in on... I'll actually be able to automate the red science packs as quickly as possible. All right, but there we go. Research has begun. Trying to bootstrap up as fast as I can here, but there's limits to how fast you can actually get this all started. Okay. So right now it's not distributing the ores quite right. That's okay. Yeah, automation is going to get us our first. Oh no, we have transport belts already. How interesting. Have they reduced the cost of our red science packs cheaper? They are. Copper plate and iron gear wheels. That's actually a lot cheaper than it used to be. I wonder when that happened. That's actually not all that unreasonable. Automation 1 should do it. I just need to get my actual ores over here. Or I need to move my science lab to a better location. That's what I need to do. If I put it down half, if I put it in between the copper and the ore, or the iron, because I want to be bringing all those materials to a central location anyways. Because things are going to get more complex with the ore processing soon. Very soon. Okay. That. Plunk it down here in the forest. Take the red science packs. And then we'll use, yeah, iron. We just need iron to start that. I wonder what it'll take to get my first electric mine, actually. More iron. And more copper, apparently. Let's make that happen right now. Because it's faster, too. Electric mine's much, much faster. Oh, excellent. And so this one is... Oh, electronics assembling, not so helpful. Logistics. Yes. There we go. Now I just need to... Now, high on the priority list, it's going to be making sure... that these power things stay powered. Okay, they're actually holding their own quite nicely. So with a bit more iron, I should be able to get that up and running. All right. Go. No problems there. I don't actually need another power plant yet, though, but I do need another mining drill. I'm going to decommission this. And then actually should look at the tech tree and see where smart inserters are. I'll have to track that down later. Here we go. Much better. So, moving as many things as possible to electric. And actually, that's the reason to get the next tier of the Angels hardware, is that's when you get the electric powered ore processing systems, which is much preferable. Okay. Alright, I'll turn all of that into stone, future use. Okay, the other thing we're going to need at some point are military weapons. Oh, but we do have the automation now, which we'll queue up because it's going to go right beside the science factory here to make a very simple automated... Also going to need to get the... inserter to get stuff out of here. Okay. So what we don't have yet are conveyor belts, which requires all the iron I don't have right now. Ah, all the running around in the early game. It's kind of funny, actually. Okay, transport belts, sure. Alright, so actually what's going to have to happen, now that I think about it, it's going to require two assembly machines. And the first one will go right there, sure. You're going to make the red science packs. Okay, a couple of those. The beginnings of automation, already there. There we go. Yes, I know this is a pretty awful layout. Okay, I'll put that right there. That right there. Okay, and then we'll need a second. All the iron. That's going to put them in. I'm hoping to have at least the concept of the... mining system in place first. Alright, we got lots of coal. Things are coming along quite nicely. Good, lots of iron too. Why the heck do I have all this, though? I don't even know how I wound up with all that. Automation. There we go. More iron, more iron. Two more inserters. There we go. Because, yeah, the primary activity of this factory to begin with is going to be making sure we have science going, going, going. Just picking up all the iron on the way. Enough to make a whole five more of those. We're almost there. Good. Okay. All right. Three more. Alright, we are so close now. There we go. Make one of those and one of those, and that will be actually all we need to get science fully automated already. Well, okay, 90%. We just have to make sure that we don't run into any trouble with our coal supply. You are going to make gears. Here we go. Science has begun. Slow science, but science nonetheless. For obvious reasons, we're going to need a lot faster of a setup later. Now what I need to do is I need to have a box that's going to siphon two more inserters to siphon off the excess from each of these production lines. There we go. So one box can go there, one box can go there, one inserter can go there, one inserter can go... no, not there. There. There's going to be a little bit of an argument over who gets the iron, but I think it'll work out okay. That works out okay, yep. And we just don't want to bottleneck the whole system. We can always hand transfer some. Let's just limit it down to about 4 stacks for now, so we don't completely burn off our supply. Okay, so the next big item on the agenda is to get... well, the last big starting item is to get mining completely off the burners. Which just means grabbing a handful more plates. We need more iron production already. Wow. Actually, we're going to be able to fix that by getting the next tier of... there we go. All right, that is the last two burners. And one electric mine for coal. Whoops. All right, let's get this tier two, this now, because that'll get us ore sorting and electric ore crusher, both of which are going to be critical to making everybody's life much easier, mostly mine. Good stuff. Okay. So. Yep, a lot more iron production. All right. That's all going to get dumped off to a box as well until further notice. Much better. Good. Yeah. So that will take care of that for the moment. We are nicely stocked on... brilliant. Now, why? Oh, we're having a brownouts. Okay. I saw that. Should have seen that coming. Everything's slowing down. 100 fuel there, and 100 fuel there. That will last us a few days. We're actually making full use of things. Okay, so that's why it was all shutting down. It thought it was running out of batteries, or, well, I should say it was running out of batteries. Okay, come on. Oh. We've probably run out of fuel. No, we've capped out on stone. I know what we can do. Oops, I didn't mean to make 5 of those, but I guess that's what we'll get. Let's siphon off. Into a box. That is filled. Every row with stone. I think that will work as a poor man's smart inserter right there. And keep that thing going. Okay, good. Now I've got to do the same thing over here for the copper, because it's going to hit the wall soon too. Yep. Alright. Put you right there. Again. Just tuck those in there. Put in our inserter, and good. Okay. That will keep the system functionally running for now. But for obvious reasons, this isn't going to be able to stand much longer. We need mechanical refining, and then we need to beeline. Well, we got enough material here. It's going to last us a little while anyways. I went with normal ore distributions, but I've gone with massively expensive tech trees. The tech later on is going to cost us, I think, it's orders of magnitude more resources. Hold on, are you okay? No, you need to be. We need to do a change of priority here. All right. Okay, so then we go like that. And then like that. That goes there. Power goes there. There we are. Priority set, more appropriately. That is so awful. I gotta fix that. That just offends my design sensibilities. There we go. Much better. Okay, science is back. Our ore production is slow but steady. We can start thinking about our first primary ore processing plant, but here's the neat thing. This is the neat part. Sapphirite ore and stearatite ore are both going to be producing copper ore and iron ore, which means I can bring both of them to the same processing facility and centralize all of my ore processing and sorting. So what I'll be doing is I will be transporting this ore as far as is possible and doing all of my crushing in a centralized location. Excellent. All the ingots. Good. The gear production is taking slight precedence, which is good. Oh, boy. Now, there's a whole bunch of stuff in here. We've got a lot of other toys that I'm eventually going to play with. I installed, one of the mods I did install, I don't know if I've mentioned, is a Roomba's light mod for YouTube, which should make it a lot easier to see what's going on at night. I mean, nighttime is good for the mood, but it's pretty awful for you guys on YouTube because it makes it almost impossible to see what's going on. All right, and here is the last item of the day, our first radar station. Ah, that'll help. A little bit more radius on that. Now, granted, there's nothing out there, but hopefully it will start exploring another block outwards for us. Radar outposts will have to wait until a little later. All right, we've got mechanical refining coming. We can find out in just a minute. I'm super happy right now. Is that running at 100? No, it's not. Okay, we are running actually under on power right now. Landfill. Okay, good. I've got the landfill mod, apparently. All right, I need smart inserters. What's that right there? That is a filter. A filter inserter? Huh. I wonder what the difference between filter inserters and smart I wonder if they've changed them. All right, well, that's green science anyway, so that ain't happening. Ooh, right. The technique for making inserters work in... I better get this. I really need my military just in case some biters decide to get persnickety on me. Persnickety. Such a good word. I like that word. Alright, let's just get a second one of those and two more of those on. There we go. That's a little more like it. All of our miners should be running a little better now. Yeah. Yeah, when the power is flickering like that, it means it's not getting enough for its purposes. It means everything will be going faster now. All right, we need stone brick. Where did I see stone brick? It's military, is it? No, not military. Alright, it's just made from stone, which we're, by the way, getting lots of here. So, actually, a couple of this. Actually, we'll just recover. And the filter inserters might be something we're going to get a little later, or sooner rather than later. I'm getting distracted. I'm supposed to be wrapping up the episode here, you know, guys. This first one, 30 minutes, good spot to stop. We're going to actually need two of them, aren't we? I'm putting these in the tree to try and keep our pollution cloud down a little early on. Good old trees. Alright. Oh, okay. Now we'll get the filter inserters. They require a fast inserter and a... Uh-oh. Electronic components means we're starting to get into crazy territory already. We might not actually be able to do smart inserters yet. We're going to have to be a little more creative, I think. Alloy processing will allow bronze. Bronze being made out of copper and tin. We're not acquiring tin yet. But I'll bet one of those ores is first and foremost tin. This is going to get so complicated, you know, guys. So complicated. Let's go with long inserters here and see what that does. Okay, stone. And why can't... Oh, do we not have the tech to do that? What's missing? It's a smelter job. Okay, I remember now. Okay. Ooh, I guess we're gonna see what these large power... They're upgrades. Oh, so nice. Whoa. That is rather... Oh, interesting. How interesting. Those are ugly as sin. How weird. I'm not actually quite sure what to do with that. It's a little bit wacky. Did I just make another one of those by accident? I probably did too, didn't I? There we go. Okay, we'll keep some of those on hand. That'll start making stone bricks. And yeah, in the next episode, we are going to completely rip all of this up and rebuild our first primary ore processing plant. Probably right out here in the open, and hope that the trees in the neighborhood help keep things under control. Well, here we go again. It's factory time. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.